Wait, would that be correlated to positive affirmations, right? Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Like you're saying something and you kind of attract it into your life.
Yeah, facts. Yeah,
that's a fact. The reason why something like that personally is scary to me is because like we talk about this a bunch on the show before, like anxiety, and sometimes you can't escape having negative thoughts. Correct?
That's a fact.
So does that work in that way also? Can you attract negativity to your life by, you know what I mean, having your mind just running like, fuck, what's wrong? What's wrong?
Yeah,
what's wrong?
That's I'm glad you mentioned that, because sometimes that's
get a little
like,
closer to the mic. I'm sorry.
Right, I got you. So like, I want to show you like this chart. It's called like the Dunning-Kruger effect. Feel me? So like,
talk to us. Come on, he had to educate y'all motherfuckers. Dude, come on,
so y'all peep, right? This is good for the camera.
Yeah. We just gonna get on the screen. They gonna see it on the screen. Don't worry about that. Nice.
But with the Dunning-Kruger effect, so like, say for instance, like it's a chart. Feel me? And then I just relate like charts and things to life. Like this is a chart. Like it's on Google. Feel me? Why is it on Google? So it's like on the left side you have the y-axis. The y-axis, which is confidence. X is wisdom. Feel me? So this always happens to everybody. Feel me? Like you could think about any situation. Like, yo, like I got this crazy idea. Feel me? I'm finna make dummy bread. So like that's kind of like your confidence is dummy high. Feel me? And your wisdom, you don't really know much about it. You just banking off of like hope and faith. Feel me? You just hype. Then you just scare a wreck. Feel me? That's how you just go from like, that's like peak amount stupid in this valley of despair. Some people can't even surpass this because you really got to like dive deep into yourself so that you can hit the slope of enlightenment. And once that shit started clicking, it's like an epiphany. Feel me? Like, wow. Plateau sustainability is GG's. Like, you just in riding a wave.
Bro, that is life right now. Yo, I'm not. Look, everyone in the studio. And this is why we have to have this nigga on right now, because he's a genius. But all y'all relate to this, right? With the podcast right now, Malcolm be knowing sometimes I just stress myself the fuck out. Because maybe right now, what is it called? The Valley of Despair?
Oh, where, yeah. Let me get the chart. Because I'll show something else.
When we first started the podcast, it was like, yo, we about to body this shit. Niggas about to be bigger than Joe Rogan, biggest show on the earth. And then you do a few episodes, it's okay. And then you just fucking hit rock bottom, right? But that's just a part of the process, I feel like. And you just allowed me to know that when you do have those days where it's like, bro, it's no confidence right now. Confidence is on zero. That's a part of the process. Damn, bro, I appreciate that.
Word, nigga, I appreciate you.
Come on, so that's why we had you on the show.
Stop playing.
And you, like, at the beginning, you said, I feel like y'all gas me too much. Nah, bro, we're not gassing you. You need to have that confidence in yourself.
I do, feel me? Word. But like, sometimes niggas be dragging it, feel me?
Ever told on a nigga? Nope. Ever squeezed a trigger? Yeah. Ever set a nigga up? Nope. Ever helped a brother out when he was down on his luck? Yeah.